Welcome in the next video on Dover Beach, a poem written by Matthew Arnold. I am Dr. Vinita Bhadoria, Associate Professor of English, Government College, Behror. In this video, I am going to explain you the remaining part of the poem, Dover Beach. The sea of faith was once too at the full, and round earth's shore lay like the folds of a bright girdle furled, but now I only hear its melancholy, long withdrawing roar, retreating to the breath of the night wind down the vast ages drear and naked shingles of the worlds. Few meanings. Girdle is belt, folds are layers. Furled means drawn or wrapped up. Melancholy, sad, gloomy. Withdrawing means retreating. Ages, banks. Drear, dull. Naked, without any layer. Shingles, loose gravel and pebbles on shore, or pieces of small stones. In these lines, the poet tells us what he is reminded of on hearing the roaring sound of the sea waves. The retreating waves tell him the story of the decreasing religious faith, the sea of faith, decreasing religious faith in the world. Religious faith surrounded man's life in olden days like a bright folded belt. It is like furled. Every man had faith in some religion. Generally, every man had faith in God and morality. But in modern scientific age, God has been dethroned and morality has become unpragmatic. To the poet, the faithless world of today appears as cheerless as the naked pebbles of the seashore when the waves have ebbed away. In other words, we can say human faith, the religious faith, and faith in fellow people once covered the earth like sea water. It was at its fullest at the tide is now. Faith covered the earth like the folds of a bright girdle folding, belt folding. Well, the comparison suggests that it was not loose but tightly attached to this world. It was the time when faith made everything easy and solved many problems, made people united and brought meaning to life. The poet regrets. He says, but now I only hear its melancholy. He regrets that those days are now past days. Faith is fading away from the society, just like the wave is from the shore. Now he only hears the sorrowful roar of the retreating steps of faith with the receding tides. He is comparing tide with that of religious faith. It only leaves behind the chill night wind whistling over the desolate beach with dull edges of the cliff and raw pebbles. The poet here creates a fearful picture of the underlying nakedness of the colorful modern world. Ah, love, let us be true to one another for the world which seems to lie before us like a land of dreams, so various, so beautiful, so new, hath really neither joy, nor love, nor light,
nor certitude, nor peace, nor help for pain. And we are here as on a darkling plain, swept with confused alarms of struggle and flight, where ignorant armies clash by night. Few important meanings. Certitude is conviction and also certainty. Darkling is fully covered with darkness. Swept with, full of, confused alarms, unknown fears, struggle and flight, lot of pain, miseries, struggles, clash, clashes, fight. In the previous stanza, the poet tries to explain that the faithless world of today is a cheerless place. In the present stanza, he again puts down his ideas about the world. The world is in fact a place indifferent to men. It appears as if it is a land of dreams. Man has many hopes from this world. He thinks that the world is beautiful place and he will be able to become perfectly happy here. But this is a delusion. Delusion is cheating, dhokha. And man is psychologically subject to. The world rather can be compared to a dark battlefield where in the darkness of the night the armies are fighting with each other. They are not knowing their friends and foes. Foes are evils. Enemies. Their minds are filled with confusion and fear. So too man is living in confusion and fear in this world. If there is any consolation in this world, that can only come from the lovers becoming true to each other. The poet entreats it from his beloved. He starts the stanza, "Ah, love, let us be true to one another." In this stanza, Arnold asks his wife to be true to each other. The desolate poet now again turns to his beloved and urges her to be faithful to each other. The dreamy modern world, which seems so beautiful with its varieties, is not really a source of joy, love, light, certainty, peace, or help for pain for the poet. The chaotic artificial world doesn't induce much hope for him. So he sees hope in only his wife. Now the poet compares this world to a dark place where we are completely unaware of what we are doing. No one can see other one. We are in a confused struggle as if ignorant shoulders are fighting with each other in the darkness without knowing who is enemy and who is friend. This is Matthew Arnold's assessment of the morally corrupted modern world full of vanity. Arnold's concept of nature can be well contrasted to that of Wordsworth, to whom man was a nature's foster child. To Arnold, nature extend no joy, love, light, certainty, peace and help to man. That he has to man is on the basis of each other's help. Nature is quite indifferent to human beings. Because he is the believer of religion, atheist, and he thought as a result of the loss of religious faith, there is nothing to support and guide to human lives. In this poem, the idea is expressed in the form of a beautiful metaphor.
Humanity is presented as a seashore, faith as the sea. In the past ages, the heart of man was full of faith, like a beach covered with sea water at the time of the flow of the tide. Today, the human heart is dry, like a beach at ebb tide. Only the dry and soulless religious formulas, ceremonies and practices remain in it, like pebbles on sea beach. Here, poet describes the landscape in a way that the reader is easily able to visualize it and its varied color. On the French coast, the light gleams and is gone. We can very easily visualize the colors here. When he speaks of the moon-blanched land, he makes us see the sandy place shining white in the moonlit night without using the colors. The poem Dover Beach has a sad music in it, like the slow, mournful beat of the waves described in it. It has that note of sadness and dissatisfaction that is so common in his writing. All things considered, it is one of the most beautiful poems in the language, simple and suggestive weight with a heavy sweetness. I have explained for you the whole poem. If you have any difficulty, you can contact me on the WhatsApp group. Thank you very much.